cars and thousands of people, and we are having church. We're here celebrating the victories that we received this week. Oh, God is putting the devil on the run. He's screaming like a stuck pig, but it doesn't make any difference. Jesus is Lord. Hallelujah. Tom, get over here. You said, here's one of our ushers here, Tom Morgan. And he didn't think that I'd put him on television. He was standing over here holding the door. Tom, you don't need to worry about whether or not it's on. Tom, I mean, you are dressed up. Tell us about our new usher's outfits.
Thanks a lot. Well, we just have the blue blazer, gray slacks, gold tie, and each uniform is set to designate whatever station an usher has in the church.
Now, as an usher at Word of Faith, what are y'all told to do and taught to do?
What are we told to do?
Besides casting out devils.
Well, primary as ushers, we're doorkeepers of the church. We're gatekeepers. And our job is to make sure that when people come to our church, that they can worship their God in peace.
Now, Tom, how long have you and your wife been coming here to Word of Faith?
7.5 years.
7.5 years. Now, 7.5 years, why do you come here? You know, of all the publicity about us and negative things that people say, is there some positive? I mean, why do you keep coming?
We keep coming here because it's the first place we've ever been in our lives that we could worship our God. And we come to church and people are happy to be here. They feel free to worship God, free to express themselves. And we've learned some really
Well, I look from which he came from. His father cannot be of God.
I believe that. What do you think about that, sir? This is we have a black brother here. You're obviously Hispanic or Italian or something, but
Cuban.
Cuban. Okay, that's even better. Excuse me. You forgive me. Did you see some of the statements that the Attorney General made?
Yes, I did.
What did you think about that?
I think that if anybody's stupid, it's he. For that, whenever before I came to this wonderful place, I felt that I was stupid because the world, all that it had to offer me was, you know, condemnation and darkness. And I'm telling everybody out there in the world that if they would come here to Word of Faith Family Church and let the light of God shine on them, that there would be nothing that they could not overcome. Because this place has shown me how to step and kick the devil out of my life and gave me prosperity and wisdom and facts. And I love this place. And I love you and your family, Bob. God bless you.
Thank you. Thank you. Praise God. We just, woo! What do you think about all this?
I'm not ignorant.
Do you take offense in him calling you that?
Yes.
You know, it amazes me that a public official makes such derogatory statements of people that would elect him into office. Now, he thinks that you folks that would come here and listen to me preach the Bible, he calls, number one, what I preach garbage. Do I preach the Bible?
Yes.
How many of you have your Bible here today? Would you hold them up for me one more time and wave them? You know, if you're going to get up here and preach garbage with this many Bibles, you don't get away with it very long. This is America, isn't it? We do have freedom to believe what we believe, don't we? This is why we left England to come to the United States, so that we get away from the religious persecution of the bigots there, didn't we? Hello? It amazes me. Anyway, this videotape will show you some of the things that happened. And I really don't like getting into it, but many of you are questioning what happened. What happened was there was a video deposition when we were suing the Attorney General, and we won that case. And he has no legal right to criminally or civilly investigate us. And we have, by the way, filed a suit against him for contempt of court, and it has already been filed. We're not going to let him get away with his mouth. And anyway, we won that case totally. And he continued to run his mouth. And so the federal judge brought him back and reprimanded him worse than any, as far as we know, any attorney general has ever been reprimanded by a federal judge. The attorney general has no power relative to the size of the power of a federal judge. And so right after the judge rebuked him and told him he should not have released this deposition, we made an agreement with their attorney generals, four of them.
Fungus on the right.
Be son, my little boy right here. He fell on the floor, and playing football in the house, of course. And he started complaining about dizziness, and he couldn't see? And so we said, we better take him to the doctor. And we took him to the doctor, and it was confirmed that he couldn't feel on one side of his body. He couldn't hardly remember. And she said that he had swelling on the brain. And they was gonna have to drill holes in his skull in order to relieve the pressure. And we didn't want to have to go to the doctor. In fact, they had a trauma room waiting at a children's medical center for him. And we said, well, we'd rather take him back home. And what we did when we got back home, me and my wife and my kids, we all put him in the center, and we laid hands on him and prayed for him. And in fact, he couldn't eat. He was throwing up, too. That was another problem he was having. He was just constantly throwing up. And she told us, when we take him home, I want y'all to, if he throws up again, immediately call an ambulance and bring him to the hospital.
So you took him home, you prayed for him. What happened?
Home and prayed for him, and he was healed. God healed him. And in fact, he stopped throwing up. He threw up when we got home. And you have a tendency to say, well, let's take him on. He threw it up just like the doctor said. Let's get him out of here. But we didn't. We prayed for him, laid hands on him. And she told him not to give him any solid food to eat. We did, and he was healed.
That's right.
Well, that is faith there, I'm telling you. I don't recommend, that's between you and God on that. It's best to do what the doctors say, but at the same time praying, but God healed that young man. Who else has had a definite, obvious miracle in your body? This gentleman right here.